شيماب وبرو روح حي قديش وحضلو شريرو امين. As we follow from the last two episodes about studies, our question to you, Giselle, do these specialists confirm the dangers of mindfulness?
Professor Willoughby Britton talks about many dangers of mindfulness technique in her article entitled Can Mindfulness Be a Very Good Thing? Published on Brown University's website, also on Science Direct website. It says that studies have confirmed that practitioners of mindfulness are physically and psychologically worse than non-practitioners, in addition to suffering from high levels of pain, headaches, stress, nervous breakdown, anxiety, insomnia, and other severe illnesses. For her part, researcher Susan Brinkman warns of the repercussions of this meditation and expresses concern about the attempt by many Christians to add the principles of mindfulness to their Christian meditation or to their spiritual life. Brinkman comments, if someone is currently living in the presence of God, then he does not need Buddhist practices such as mindfulness. She adds that Christian practices are far superior to these human ways, and they lead us to the presence of God in which the fullness of healing and peace. Brinkman has fully understood what it means to seek happiness in ambiguous areas and has devoted her life to sharing the good news of her Christian faith in her book. In her book, she warns of the dangers of this new technique of East Asian meditation and offers Christians a deeper sacred bond rooted in the wisdom of the saints and father of the Holy Church. Brinkman emphasizes at the beginning of her speech that mindfulness is rooted in Buddhist traditions and is practiced through several forms of Buddhist meditation, such as special meditation, body scanner, and expanded meditation of consciousness. She says that communicating with the Lord has nothing to do with any of these forms of meditation. Unfortunately, the believers are ignorant of the fact that this meditation is Buddhist, and they try to mix it in their Christian meditation and prayer because they imagine that it helps them not to be distracted and focus on the present moment. But it seems that when they practice it in its many forms that we have mentioned, they enter the world of Buddhist practices. Some of them may begin practicing mindfulness separately from their Christian meditation, but Westerners have great ambiguity regarding East Asian meditation, which is a mental exercise, while Christian meditation is a dialogue with God. They mix it together without realizing it. This leads them, and this has happened repeatedly, to spiritual chaos that some of them even need prayers of liberation.